Pulse width modulator. Pulse width modulator. These can't possibly do the same thing. Greetings, fellow DIYer, and welcome to my video. As I've been doing various treadmill projects and posting videos, I have gotten a lot of different questions about PWM, or pulse width modulation. Put very simply, pulse width modulation is an electrical signal that is doing what the name suggests. It is pulsing. This is a pulse width modulator power supply. It's an MC2100 used to control a treadmill. This is a pulse width modulator signal generator, not used to power a treadmill, but used to control an MC2100 to power a treadmill. Programming this is fairly simple. I've gone over that in a couple of my videos, and it's a fantastic way to control something like this. A pulse width modulator is something that sends an electrical signal in a pulsing nature that is specific. So it may pulse one time a second, it may pulse 100 times a second, it may pulse 1,000 times a second, and anywhere in between. That on-off pulsing is what makes something a pulse width modulator. Now, in the case of a power supply, a pulse width modulator is used to control voltage. The power coming out of this, turning off and on, has the effect of reducing the voltage. So you've got 120 volts coming in from the wall. It's then with the bridge rectifier being converted to DC. And then the other circuits in this board are causing that power to turn on and off, at a very specific rate. The faster it pulses, the higher the voltage becomes. This is controlled by a pulse width modulator signal generator, which is this right here. It's doing the exact same thing, off on, at a prescribed rate to control things. The pulsing nature of this tells this when to turn on and off. The biggest difference is amperage. This is not designed to have massive amounts of electricity flowing through it. This is designed for very low voltage, very low amperage, just a very small signal. And this is designed to have high amperage and high voltage. So even though they are both PWMs, this one is for signal generation and this one is a power supply. Now there are other pulse width modulators out there. You can find them on eBay, you can find them on Amazon. And the way they work is you put DC current in and it will pulse on and off just like this does right here. The problem with most of those is there's a limitation on voltage and amperage. It may have a 50 volt max, or it may only put out 5 amps. Now, what does that mean in English? If it's got a 50 volt max and you're using a 100 volt motor, your motor is going to run at half speed. That's the fastest you're ever going to get it to go. So that's part of why you have to be concerned with those type units. The other thing you have to be careful of is amperage. In the case of a motor, a solid magnet DC motor, amperage has everything to do with torque. If it's a 16 amp motor, it may run on 5 amps, but there is a direct correlation between amperage and torque. So if you are only pushing 5 amps through a 16 amp motor, you are going to have significantly less torque. It's that amperage that creates the magnetic field that creates the force. So I hope that clears things up. This is a pulse width modulator signal generator, and this is a pulse width modulator power supply.
If you like what you've seen, please click like. If you'd like to see more, please subscribe. Thanks for watching.